Let's get some pumpage going. We got a big day today. Another big one on the list, on the menu, but we're gonna get warmed up. A little bit of upper body pumpage, I think, today. We'll see about it. Well, Friday morning pumps. Dude, there's like a big old queue in Lost Ark right now. That's crazy. Lost Ark is popping off, dude. Oh, baby. If we can't get through that queue, we're going to be playing some WoW this morning, but we'll see. But yeah, we're going to do our workout, and then we're going to play a little bit of games. Then me and Jenny are going to do some cooking, fire up some sweet, sweet every plate meals. Then do a little more gaming. And let's see what's up. Take a break and get back to it tonight. That's the plan. Big pumps today. Big pumps. Let's see what we can do, huh? Should be able to hopefully work towards that plus 18 weapon again today. Oh man. I don't know where we're gonna get the solars for it, but we'll see. We will see. Let's spend a little time in that infinite chaos or something. Might have to. See about it. I'll probably do some arms and shoulders, maybe some chesties. You see 2+20 weapons already? I mean, like, yeah, people will be getting there. We'll get there. But yeah. It's gonna take a while. But yeah, lots of mats coming our way. This new event and whatnot. Oh, you mean you're talking about my biceps, right? No, they might be plus 17. Not quite plus 20. They might be plus 17 though. Working on them. Working on them. They look they nice, nice. I mean, if you want to test them lungs, deadlifts with rower and box jumps, that'll get them lungs working, for sure. Sounds like it to me, at least. Yeah, that's our plan for today. It'll be a big pumper day. And you know what's really sweet? Is that today's me and Jenny's 6-year wedding anniversary. Gonna do a little cooking stream together for him. He's sweet, huh? Current workout split. Get in the gym, get some exercise every day if I can. Maybe upper lower. It's kind of an approximation of it. Could still be push-pull legs, kind of, but sometimes it ends up being upper lower. Couple rest days sprinkled in there. A little different than sometimes, but that's all right. That's all right. That's okay. We're working hard these days. Focusing really quite a bit of time and energy into the content creation and our job at the moment, which is good, it's going well. It's a good time to push. But the gains are almost just kind of in maintenance mode right now. It truly isn't bad. Just a little different sometimes. But the games sometimes take a higher priority. Right now, we're just using that discipline and staying in rhythm and letting the workouts kind of help us be effective at everything else we want to do, which is good habits. Good habits. These workouts to get warmed up and get it going. You do chest, shoulders, tries, next day back, legs, buys, 2 days rest, repeat. Wow, okay. It's insane, huh, deep six? Pretty wild. All right. Is for a survivor's commitment with me? Nah, I'm not buying that. I'm a dream husband. Bringing home the bacon, sweet as can be, smoking bod. I'm a dream husband. Not buying that. But she is my dream wife too, so it works both ways. Nope. Oh my goodness. That's just the truth. Did you write down too? Nice, Kyle, nice. Huge fan, tell you just a little something, something. The one thing that I would do feel pain is if you were looking at something different, I would do back and legs on different days. So 3 days on, 1 day off is kind of like what I recommend instead of 2 days on, 1 day off. But you keep doing whatever's working for you. Whatever you like, and whatever is working. Pretty overweight right now. If you're trying to shred fat, what would you do in the gym outside of deficit? I would train for whatever my goals are. But like good old high volume training is pretty fun. But yep, ain't no escaping that deficit. That's what's gonna do it. That's what's gonna do it. But yeah, man, I like good old training the way I train. It's the good stuff. I don't drink soda, no. And Ronde, thank you so much, man, for the 2 months, man. Appreciate it, dude. Yeah, but if you're doing deadlifts and rows, that sounds like a back day to me, brother. That's high volume, just a lot of work. Usually like fairly high rep sets, like bodybuilding range sets. Yep. That's a 1400, but it's a pretty bad honing session considering 39.9. Yeah, did you see my honing session yesterday? Wasn't too nice to me, but that's all right. That's how it goes, dude. Just on the grind. On the grind. I train 3 times a week, but I don't eat. How do you eat? How do I eat personally, or just how does one eat more? Make it a priority and get it done. That's how it goes. Get you some every plate. I'll teach you how to cook, too. Exclamation mark every plate. Get you some of that. Get on it. Oh. Do it to it. Uh-oh, that sucks, T-Sonic. Careful now. Somebody doesn't call for food, that's okay. Doesn't matter, you gotta eat if you wanna grow. Doesn't matter if your stomach is calling for it or not, you gotta do the shit. That's how it works. Sounds good, Jay, what's up, man? That's how it goes. Can't be waiting for your stomach to tell you to eat if you need to eat. Got work to do. Yep, gotta do it. And you don't have to eat yourself sick, you just need to establish some habits. But you got this. The fact that you're asking about it means that you're interested in doing it, so you got the impetus. Now it's time to take action. We got this. You got this. But yeah, a lot of times when it comes to making changes, you've got to do something different than just what you feel like doing. Or what you've been doing, you know what I mean? Might have to get a little uncomfortable. But you got this. If you type exclamation mark nutrition, it'll give you some idea of what you should shoot for in terms of your calorie intake. And you can go from there. But like I said, every plate is a great way to get some nice, tasty, healthy meals inexpensively sent to your door. We're going to do a cooking stream with them today. It'll be fun. Be nice. Nice question. That's fine. Your goal is to build muscle? Okay. Your mindset is cardio to get the weight down and start lifting? No. Lift now. Yeah, lift now. You'll lose fat in deficit of calories. Yeah, you've been here long enough to know that I'm gonna tell you. But maybe now you're interested, so you start listening. But yeah, train, lift weights. There's no reason not to lift weights. Cardio is just gonna burn calories for you and help you build more cardiovascular capabilities and all that good stuff, but if you wanna lift weights at any point, if you wanna build muscle at any point, you may as well do it now. No, it will impact your weight loss positively. Building muscle is going to be a good thing.
Yeah. Right now is actually a unique time where you can build muscle and lose fat at the same time.
Because you're new and overweight. You got this. You're prime. You're prime for the big gains. No reason to sit around. You know that I'm going to tell you to train for your athletic goals and diet for your aesthetic goals. So if you're like, oh, athletic goals are muscle building, you're going to be training in a hypertrophy range, in good volume, and you're going to be eating that deficit. Got this. You got this, bro. But yeah, you already know what I'm going to tell you because you've been here for a long time. But I don't want to tell you again. I got your back. But it's nothing new. Nothing new.
You're a skinny guy trying to work out at home due to anxiety. Okay, first of all, let me answer your question. Would home workouts be a safe way to start gaining, even if just small gains? Yeah, you need to eat enough. But you also, there's no reason to let anxiety hold you back from doing things that are good for you, like going to the gym, if that's something that you want to do. Training at home is great too, though. The diet can go on too long, sure. Yeah, definitely a good idea to reverse diet out of a diet eventually. Yep. Yep. And good job, man bear. Good job. Yep. Watched an interesting interview with Brandon Curry, first pro bodybuilder I've heard that doesn't track calories. Everything by the food scale. He's putting food on a food scale. He's tracking his food. He probably has a coach too that just makes all that for him anyway. It's the same thing. He's putting food on the food scale. He's being consistent with his intake. He's tracking his calories whether he is thinking about it or not. He probably, once again, he probably has a coach who designs all his meals for him, so he doesn't have to do anything. He just has to do this shit, right? Just because he doesn't mindfully do it doesn't mean that's not being done, you know what I mean? Right, Jamin, but it's the same thing is what I'm telling you. It's not different. It's the same thing. Did starting training for the pandemic and I saw good noob gains when I lost it all during the pandemic. You didn't lose it. You'll get it back, don't worry.
You'll be alright.
Yeah. Would you rather active rest or completely take a day off? Active rest, preferably. Uh-huh. Yep.
It's a fine way to recover.
Especially if you're like, if you enjoy the activity, then yeah, it's even better. It makes your whole day better, right? Aw. Congrats, Liz. That's so exciting, dude. Arch is doing great, man. Turns 3 next month. Insane. Insane. Wait, what, Banbury? Yeah. Pretty crazy all this, though. The time's gonna fly for you, too. It's gonna be weird. Some Makoko, you mean? Okay.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I haven't really been farming Makokos too hard. So, I'm not in the loop on some of that. Ooh-yah. I mean, like, you can go for a walk if you want to. It's a crime after you're training to eat junk food? Well, for you, if you're struggling to eat anything, it's better than nothing. But, no. But once again, you need to type exclamation mark nutrition like I told you and watch that video. These are Bose earbuds, but they don't exactly... I mean, you might just want to get like a different attachment for your headphones, right? They're pretty okay, but they can also fall out if you try hard enough. They can fall out if you try hard enough. Or you can get the ones that go over your ears too, right? Old school. The back in the day stuff. What's up, Lance? Morning, dude. How's my interview? It's great. It's on YouTube too if you want to check it out. Exclamation mark PVP interview. Yeah, man. It is kind of important to me that we just finish that discussion that you do understand that putting food on a food scale is tracking your food, right? And that he has a coach who has determined what all food he should eat at the end, in the exact quantities, tracking calories and macros for him, right? So all he has to do to follow through is put the food on the scale, right? So I want to make sure that you understand that. What's up, Quentin? Just want to make sure that we're on the same page. There we go. This is pretty cool about Brandon Curry. I used to watch him run track. Pretty neato. Back in the day in Tennessee. Pretty cool. Whoever disagrees with the thing that's the same is really hitting the nail on the head. If you disagree that it's not the same, putting food on your food scale and hitting the numbers that you need to hit, you just don't think about the calories. If whether you think about it or not, you're doing this thing. You're doing the thing. But why do you think you put food on a food scale, I guess, is my question. Like, what do you think you're doing when you do that? See, there's not some magical property of the food scale that infuses it with weight loss or weight gain. You're keeping your calories consistent. You're making sure you're eating the right amount for your plan. Whether you're thinking about the mechanism of why something works is kind of irrelevant because that's still why it works, right? So. Whether or not you're thinking about the calories is like irrelevant. Whether or not you're thinking about the room temperature, it'll determine whether you're comfortable or not is still part of the deal or something like that, right? I guess I'll ask you a question. You calculate the calories you want and the weight to hit that cal... That, in this case, he wants a weight for the thing of the weight's sake. No? No, he wants to eat the right amount of food to eat the right amount of food. And how you track the right amount of food is by weight. A certain amount of this amount of this food contains this amount of calories and macros. It's not weight for weight's sake. It's weight in order to get the right amount of nutrition and energy out of the food. Because that's how you measure food's energy, by weight. It's easy to do it that way instead of like burning it and seeing how much calories comes out. Why are you timed out? You accidentally put a link. You didn't put a space after the period.
So the bot just took you out. That's why you measure your food, is so you know what's in it. You're getting the right amount of food. Whether you're thinking about the calories that's in it is irrelevant. Because that's why you're eating that amount of food, because it contains that amount of calories. And that amount of macronutrients. Which is why I talk about that a lot. So I just want you to make sure that you understand why that's happening. Because that can help you in your journey as well. But it's not a departure from the method, it's actually the same thing. Whether or not you're thinking about it or not, right?
Sounds good, Kyle. I usually work out just about every day. Let's see. Generally not every day. I haven't been doing the gym streams every single day because sometimes I've actually been working out outside, which has been really nice. With some sunlight. So the schedule's been a little tight sometimes. That's fine, Jamin. That's why I'm giving you the info so we can have a clear understanding. Because if your coach tells you to eat 6 ounces of chicken and you measure 6 ounces of chicken, even if you're not thinking about the calories, your coach has already thought about the calories and macros, so all you have to do as an athlete is just put the food on a food scale and make sure it says 6, and then you're good to go. But the reason why you're being instructed to eat 6 ounces of chicken for that meal is because that amount of chicken has a certain amount of calories and macros that are going to contribute to your daily calorie and macro goals. If you, the athlete, doesn't have to calculate it because your coach already did it. I have not, Alec, no. Favorite movement? I don't know. Hex bar deadlifts are pretty fun. Usually the movements that I do here are kind of the ones I like. I mean, as long as you're consistent with your measurements, it'll even out over time. Is chicken breast the best for gains food? No. It is a source of, you know, pretty easy lean protein, though. But that's not really how food works. It's not really like just the best gains food. No, it's just easy to cook and eat and whatever source of protein. Not usually real expensive either. Pretty popular. Oh. It's like if you have like an accountant who says, hey, if you want to save up money, you need to make sure that you don't spend more than this and that you put this amount into savings. And it's like, okay. So just because you don't know all the mechanics behind it because you paid somebody to do that for you, as long as you don't spend more than this and put this amount into savings, like you're still accomplishing your goal, right? But that's like saying, I don't really track the amount of money I spend. It's like, okay. Yeah. When I Google tracking by grams versus calories, there's a good amount of content. Right, so tracking the grams is how you track the calories, right? So if there's This is completely made up. Just numbers. If there's 20 grams of protein for like 4 ounces of chicken, then you say, okay, if I want to have 20 grams of protein, I need to make sure I have 4 ounces of chicken on the food scale. Or you can do grams to grams, that's fine too. Right? But you don't know how many calories is in the food until you measure it on a food scale. Like that's how you keep it consistent, I should say. It's the same thing. That's what I'm telling you. It's the same thing. Knowing how many, getting the right amount of calories is achieved by tracking and being consistent with the amount of food that you're intaking. And you usually measure the amount of food you're eating by its weight or its mass with grams, right? So tracking the amount of food you're eating is the same thing, right? I'm pissed? No, I'm definitely not pissed, no. I'm trying to be clear, I'm trying to be like helpful, but no, I'm not pissed, no. You can be passionate and emphatic without being mad, right? Hopefully. Hopefully you see people be passionate without thinking it's anger. I'm trying to be helpful. I'm trying to think of like a good comparison here. It's like if you're trying to buy sand. Like I want to have $100 worth of sand for my sand pit. How much is sand? Well, it's 1 cent per pound. It's like, okay, well, measure me out however much sand I need and I'll pay for that, right? It's like how do you take a quantity of something and assign a value to it, right? That's just how it is. It's not rocket science. No, it's not, but we're working through it. I'm doing like bad comparisons, but it's like it's how it actually is, so. 1 gallon of water is no calories, but yeah, I see what you're saying. Yeah. Make a good comparison, you mentioned 200 grams chicken, not the same as 200 grams salmon, I guess, but maybe. Maybe also not. Right, different amounts of food have different calorie and macro amounts. Yeah, true. Right. What has me worried is that Jamin, despite hanging out here for over a year, has missed this information somehow. But we're getting him. We're getting him. We'll get him with understanding, and then he'll be free to make his gains a little bit more easily, a little bit more clear understanding of how that works. We'll keep working on it. That's how it goes. We'll keep working on it. Hopefully it helps. Keep working on them. Good. Glad the boomers are returning. Very good. All right. Collagen versus whey? In my understanding, collagen is just another source of protein, right? I just generally have whey protein in terms of my supplement, but I haven't gotten into collagen supplementation. Hey, thanks for the 88 months of the Prime, dude. Welcome back, man. Big ol' flexes for you, dude. Appreciate it, man. And thank you, dude. Appreciate it. I think people sometimes take collagen for, like, their skin and hair, but it sounds like to me it's just digested as a normal protein, right? So. Jim Fitz, I got the games and game shorts on, yep. Yep. Hepist info, okay. Let me see. Your specific sticking point is that this individual seems to create a distinction between tracking food for macros and not calories. Okay, I mean, it's just It's not accurate, but it's fine. What I didn't say is there's an alignment between all the macro sources and consistent calorie numbers across fast, protein, etc. Okay, gotcha. Why would you bother making a distinction then? Because he, as an athlete, doesn't need to worry about the numbers of calories and macros. That's for his coach to determine. He just needs to put the right amount of food in his body. So when his coach says, for this meal, you need to eat this amount of rice, this amount of chicken, this amount of veggies or whatever, he just needs to make sure that he puts that food on a food scale, gets the numbers right, and eats it. That's all he's got to do. Because his coach is doing the planning for the numbers. Right? That's how that works. And whether he's thinking about it or not, if somebody says, I'm just going to eat a full plate of food 3 times a day, and then adjust depending on what happens to my body, that's still a type of consistency where they are eventually over time going to be tooling the amount of calories and macros they put into their body, even if they're not thinking about it. That's just what's happening. Like it or not, right? So. But my suspicion is, as a pro athlete, pro bodybuilder, has a coach telling him how much food to eat, how much sleep to get, how much training to do, how much drugs to take, right? So he doesn't have to do anything except just do that stuff. He doesn't have to actually worry about the tinkering and tweaking. But even if he is doing it all on his own, and all he's doing ever is measuring the food, he's still changing his calorie and macro amount depending on what he wants to do, right? So. Whether or not that's what he's mindfully doing, that is what he is in actuality doing, right? It's adjusting his calories and macros for his goals. Doing so by achieving consistency by putting it on a food scale. I'm just gonna ban you, I think. I don't know. That's a different sort of thing right there. It's a dingus. No, collagen isn't. My understanding is collagen is just another dietary protein. It's just a diet like good, but that helped.
Not banning Jamin. Banning the other random weirdo. Oh boy. Alright. But you didn't realize that the calories could come out. I'm trying to figure out where you were hung up on. But whatever.
Awesome, Rocco. Way to work, dude. Way to work. Any exercise I avoid doing?
Things that hurt. I don't do a lot of dips. I guess that's one example. I don't do a lot of dips. I think a lot of people hopefully have been checking out and enjoying that PP to me. Appreciate it. I mean, it's nothing really special about me. It's just very kind that Blizz decided to give me the opportunity to have a chat. But I'm glad people like it. Definitely was pretty fun to chat with my buddy. That's for sure. You lost art today?
Yeah, of course.
Probably lost art all day, except for the cooking part. Doing some cooking action with Jenny. That'll be fun. Like hex bar deadlifts, I mean, they're easier and more comfortable. They're pretty fun.
But they're the same movement, right? It's like sort of similar, but not really the same, right? It's like liking a leg press more than a squat. Leg press is easier, but also different, you know? So. But yeah, I do like the X bar a lot. They're easy to throw in a workout. Not quite like a big recovery demand on them most of the time, unless you get real heavy. I don't think there's much wrist. Not like much wrist strain on a deadlift. Creatine's great, yeah, definitely. Definitely. Been good. Pendulum squats? Yeah, I don't think I've ever done those. They do look pretty cool if they are what I'm thinking of. I can't take creatine makes your face fat. Creatine doesn't make your face fat. Face fat makes your face fat. But I guess different people respond differently to creatine, I suppose. I'll start there, yeah, of course. Of course. We'll do our normal day stream and then night stream I'll start for sure too, yep. Don't skip legs day. Is that just, oh, I noticed you're working out. Let me drop something clueless in the chat. Is that what that was? What's my body fat, 12%, maybe. Something like that, yeah. And we stream Lost Ark probably 10 hours a day. We spent an hour exercising real quick. All right, first timer, yeah, probably.
Are you working out? Don't skip leg day.
Yeah, okay. My legs are probably literally the size of your torso. But we'll keep pumping them. Not done yet. Not done yet. Still got work to do. On them legs. More work to do. We are a little bit on the leaner side though, that's for sure. Just kind of feels about right for some reason to stay a little leaner right now. With the amount of time that we're spending on our kind of like content creation goals, using the gym kind of just get the day started, stay in rhythm is been working pretty well for us overall, I'd say. You wanna see? Well, my legs are actually looking kind of nuts these days. Kind of with the getting a little leaner. Not especially pumped right now, but I don't know.
Don't skip leg day, teehee.
Yeah. Ain't skipping no days, bro. Watch out now. Ain't skipping no days.
Don't skip leg day.
There we go. Yep. Just make a decision and quit doing it, Emilio. Yeah, it's not something that you do anymore. Easy peasy. Easy peasy.
Make a decision, cut it out.
Easy as that. How's the back looking? It's probably all right. Work in progress, as always. Been doing a lot of pull-ups though. Probably do a little pull-up today, as a matter of fact. We got work to do though. On the old back.
Yeah. Still gotta get them leggies going. I know everyone's different, but when you started working on definition, was your legs and shoulders the first to form? My legs and shoulders still haven't formed. My shoulders still aren't defined. I was a distance runner in high school and college, and I played sports all the way through, ever. So my legs are like okay, but I think a lot of the leg development was done running miles, man. Never done 4 plates on bench though. 355 was my best. But yeah, still doing a lot of leg training with weights and stuff, but I think a lot of that foundation is probably from running.
Yep.
Like a leg shoulder now? Good, good. My shoulders are definitely a work in progress here.
Abs, question mark? Yeah, we're pretty low body fat, so abs are in.
For plenty fine for off season. Abs are in.
You guys can follow me on Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, all that stuff for the Swolfies. The training's been a little lighter recently, but still getting in and getting something done, you know?
It counts, probably not. We'll see. We'll see. Only fancy dabs. Yeah, you can super follow me on Twitter for that, right? You same as 185-170. I don't know how I did it. Probably slow and steady gains, man. It's good.
Slow and steady gains. Eating, training, gaining. Good stuff. Good stuff. I guess that's your goal. But chances are, you probably don't look the same. If somebody else were to be able to tell the difference. But you might feel the same. And you might feel like you look the same. I feel you on that. As someone who's been doing this for a while, sometimes it's hard to tell. But you might ought to have to give yourself a little credit too. But then the other goal is, if you don't really look the way that you want to look, how can we help you with that?
Yeah. I'd recommend someone getting lifting who's never done it. Slowly. Light. A trainer is kind of hit or miss. I stream my training live every day and I have like a billion YouTube videos about working out, so that might be a place to start. What do you think about body recon versus cutting? Those are just two different goals.
Guess which one's your goal? Have you been out of the gym for a while? Or like what you've been up to, because a recomp is almost has more to do with your like what you've been up to until, whereas cutting is like all right, so I guess just in general it kind of depends on what you've been up to and what your goals are next. Man, oh man.
Oh, nice. We still got time to train. It's good. Thanks, Lance. Squat Universe on Instagram? I think I've seen some of their videos. Seems cool. Yeah, I feel like trainers are definitely hit or miss. So, there's tons of free information out there online, too. So, yeah. Oh, no, that sucks, Hammy. Your husband would kill for this setup! I ain't gotta kill nobody, just... might gotta save up a little bit, but yeah, it's lovely. I'm very grateful. Ain't gotta kill nobody. Ugh. Wanna put on some weight? Alright. Time to eat. Yeah, time to eat.
Good for Guild Wars 2, that's awesome. It's a great time for MMOs. We had a lot of fun with our Guild Wars 2 stream. Barely scratched the surface, but it felt good to play it. It was fun. Great time for MMOs. Yeah, Lost Ark had a massive queue this morning too. And it was its 30-day peak at this morning. It's pretty crazy. Popping off, man. Popping off.
Man, oh man. Oh wow. Awesome. He'd kill for once again. I gotta kill nobody. I just gotta save up a little bit. Just gotta get to work on it, right?
Got this. I gotta kill nobody. It is a wonderful setup, though. Like I said, I'm very grateful. Try to get in here and put it to work. On the regs. On the daily. Man, oh man.
It happens. Awesome, Kayla, awesome. When you see people put chains on the bar, if the chains actually hit the ground, it creates more resistance as you go up. Because some of the chain doesn't need to be supported by, you know, the gravity takes some of the weight of the chain off. If they just have chains on it and never touches the ground, that's just adding more weight to it. But yeah, if the chains actually ever take weight off, or like resting, then a portion of the chain doesn't have to be lifted, so it gets more heavy as you go up. Kind of like a band. Same idea. The further you press, the more resistance you're gonna get. But I think the weight that you get from a chain is more consistent than the weight that you get from a band, I would imagine. But yeah, it's just different. Yep. Yeah, maybe don't immediately try to go back to benching whatever you were before if it's your first day back. So not just for show. Potentially. But maybe a little for show. Am I gonna roll Drakthyr? I don't think so. Maybe I'll make one, like, for fun in the beta and check it out, but I don't think a mage is gonna be my, or something I re-roll to. But I suppose we'll see. Definitely interested to see what's happening, but I mean, like, that's a year out too. We'll see what's up. 171 buff. Cool. Cool. I mean, they're probably like very quickly responding to the feedback, right? But then we're gonna definitely need a Drakthyr Warrior for the buff one. You can't be playing a buff-ass little weenie mage. But a buff Drakthyr Warrior, then we have to consider that, yes. Yeah, we'd have to think about that. Finally a Sentinel 2 dragon form. That would be hype. Big Town, thanks so much for those 54 months, man. And of course, Big Flex for you. Thank you, man. What up?
What up, dude?
Welcome back. I think I need to fix the alert sound, don't I? Probably. There we go.
Sup, sup.
Got a little bit more time to live, then we gotta get on to the next thing. Gotta get on to work. If I'm through that lost heart queue yet. See about it. Get some Lost Arkin going, get warmed up, and then get ready for a cooking stream. That'd be fun, huh? Start chipping away at them dailies. Maybe do some honing? We'll see. We gotta hit up the dungeons today too, get those hard modes done. Maybe even think about hitting up the old Argos. Argos could be tonight though. We gotta see what the homies are up to, see what everybody's thinking. Go slap up Argos a bit. Yeah. My max rest for chins, I don't know, I usually do like 8 to 10. Yeah, every plate is sponsoring our stream this month. That's what we're working on today with Jenny. Should be good. The food that we made last time was really good, and the food that we made over the weekend from that was really good too, so.
Decided to do more of that. Should be great.
Man. They're pre-made meals? No. We've done stuff with them too. With Factor. It's great. But these are just really easy to cook meals. They send you the ingredients. Yeah. You cook them up real quick. So the thing that's unique about this one is they're still good healthy meals with fresh ingredients, but they're really inexpensive. The goal is to make $1.79 per meal. It's kind of crazy. Pretty crazy. Yeah. Yeah. Same parent company, Banbury. Yeah. Like I said, just the unique thing about this one is that the meals are designed to be very inexpensive. Every plate, exclamation mark every plate. You'll be seeing them in an hour or so once we get into the gaming stream. Which will be soon. That'll be fun.
Yep. Check them out. Show them some love. Use our link. Get
yourself some savings. I mean, honestly, it's just a nice way to save on groceries for the month, you know? Using our code. It's pretty cool. But yeah, the food's been really good. Really enjoyed it. And I like doing these cooking streams with Jenny. I think it's because they get them direct, Slayric. They have like their own direct connection with the stuff. It's pretty cool. So it saves you time and money having to go to the grocery store and stuff too. I meant your personal opinion? What's my opinion on why they're such low cost? Well, I don't know if that's like an opinion sort of thing. I think it's just because they have, like, their, like, direct access to farmers and stuff. Right? Yeah. I don't even think it's an opinion sort of thing. Yeah. But, I also don't think that eating healthy is very expensive. But $1.79 is very inexpensive, yeah.
It's pretty crazy.
So those weigh, they're 20 pounds, they're not very heavy. This little pumper weights. It is good quality food, yeah, it's nice. This little pumpers.
That's a little Friday morning pump before we get on with the rest of our day. That's what you need though sometimes. Oh, that's what you need. It's little pumpers. Friday morning pump. Get this thing started.
Uh. Not sure what next bike we chose. We'll see. Maybe this summer, or maybe not for a while. The pandemic continues to do its thing. We'll see. Until You Fall. What's that one? I don't think I've seen that one. Maybe try. We're a little bit leaner than sometimes, yeah. But I'm not sure what competition factors into that. But I think just being a little leaner for chasing Archer around has been good for my overall life. So yeah, this kind of makes sense. Definitely a little leaner than sometimes though in the off season, yeah. But I feel good. That'll do. About time to get going. Roguelite slash fantasy sword fighting game VR. Oh, that sounds fun. Yeah, that sounds awesome. Sounds right up my alley. Very cool. No, we've actually started incorporating meat back in the diet a little bit, Hammy. We got the quick prep meals. The ones that only take like 20-30 minutes to prep. That's nice for us, just in general. I think it'd also be good for the stream too. Just whip something up. But yeah, we've been working meat back in just a little bit, varying the protein sources. It just feels good. This feels good. But all right, guys, been kind of a shorter workout, but we got a busy day today, so we better get moving. Good to get in here and get a little pump, hang out, chat it up. I'll see you guys on the gaming stream in just a few minutes. Hopefully the Lost Ark queues are done with. We'll see. But either way, thanks for watching. Appreciate the love. Make sure you follow the stream, and I'll see you guys in a few minutes for the games. Peace.